Welcome to the Payment Book Guide for Beginners series.
Let me see who the is here. Oh, it's Lost Signer.
No worries, watch this video and you'll easily get the hang of it. Firstly, Lost Signer has Cryo Rays and Pyro Rays in the first and third stages, respectively. Therefore, the main DPS of our team needs to avoid those two elements of Cryo and Pyro in order to maximize the damage dealt. Mingguan, Shikanoin Haizo, Catching, Tartaglia, etc. are all good choices. Here I've chosen Mingguan as the main DPS. It's recommended to have one shielder and two healers for the team to ensure survival. If you're confident in your gameplay, you could replace one healer with a sub-DPS character who can boost damage and provide off-field damage abilities to improve efficiency. Among the shielders, I recommend Yona, Soma, Layla, Zhongli. For healers, Barbara, Bennett, Yayao, and Kokomi are good options. And for sub-DPS, Xingqiu, Fiscal, Nahida, and Mona are recommended. In this video, we will use Mingguang, Xingqiu, Diona, and Bennett as an example team. Next, we'll discuss the recommended artifacts and weapons for these characters. Feel free to take screenshots for reference.
I won't hold you back.
Let's get started with the challenge of the Lost Signer weekly boss fight. Narukami Island, Tenchukaku. Lost Signer's first ability with Signer fires 3 shots of ice, then launches a frozen wheel in a curved manner. We can dodge this by circling her and dashing, then approach to attack her after dodging. Lost Signer's second ability. When 3 ice spots appear in front of Lost Signer, she will fire 3 ice lotuses towards the player. Keep moving to avoid taking damage from them. The lotuses will explode after a short period of time and can cause the floor to freeze. Standing on the frosted floor will take continuous damage. We need to stay away from the frosted floor or enter with shields. Lost Signer's third ability. When 5 ice spots appear behind Lost Signer, she will launch 5 icy spikes that home in on the player character one after another, sprinting at the last second will help you dodge this attack. Don't forget to return to the Hearts of Flame in the rooms for corners after dodging to empty the sheer cold gauge over the HP bar. This way, you can avoid continuous HP loss. Lost Signer's fourth ability. When Lost Signer raises her hands, she will immediately summon an ice sphere that quickly strike towards the player, dealing cryo AO damage and explode in a second cryo AO damage upon impact and leaving frosted floor. This ability is quite difficult to dodge by sprinting, so using shields is recommended. Lost Signer's fifth ability. When Lost Signer turns around and disappears, she will teleport to the player character's position and deal AO damage if you are close enough to her. She will use the ability without moving. It is recommended to carefully observe and sprint to dodge Lost Signer's sixth ability. When ice flower patterns appear on the ground where the character walks, Lost Signer will rain down ice spheres in a small area, leaving frosted floor could be dodged by leaving the range of ice flowers on the ground. In addition, there are hearts of flame placed around the edges that can decrease the sheer cold gauge. They not only empty the sheer cold gauge, but also clear the frosted floor. However, the refresh time of Hearts of Flame is quite long, so it is not recommended to break them unless in an emergency situation. Lost Signer's seventh ability. When she summons multiple ice swords hovering above the character's head, it could be dodged by sprinting at the moment they fall. Using shields is also recommended if you're not confident with your timing. After we are familiar with Lost Signer's 7 abilities, we can easily damage her to 1/6 of her health by seizing the gaps of those abilities. Moving on to the second stage of Lost Signer. She will protect herself in ice cocoon and generate an ice barrier. During this phase, Lost Signer will continuously use lock-on target ice shards and explosive ice lotuses. We could use elemental reactions to destroy the barrier, but it's quite low in efficiency. It's recommended to pick up Crimson Lotus Moths at nearby ice cocoon, then attack it. Repeat this process 4 times to destroy the ice barrier. Once destroyed, we enter the third stage of the weekly boss fight. Lost Signer will not attack unless you move up or strike her first. If you are patient, you can take this opportunity to replenish your team status. Lost Signer's 8th ability. When you approach Lost Signer and she lifts her whip vertically, she will perform a straight line attack in front of her. We can dodge it by moving left and right. If she lifts her whip horizontally, she will perform 2 horizontal AO whip attacks. We can avoid all whip attack by walking around behind her. Lost Signer's 9th ability. She summons a Hellfire Butterfly that homes in on the player and deals continuous pyro damage on contact. It will disappear if attacked. Lost Signer's 10th ability. There is a chance that Lost Signer will turn into a red butterfly and reposition herself. She can avoid any damage taken while repositioning and leaves embered earth on her trail. It's similar to the frosted floor, but with pyro damage. Lost Signer's 11th ability. When Lost Signer charges with red lights, She will summon a flock of small hellfire butterflies in front of her and leaving embered earth. Stay away from her to avoid damage from those butterflies. After that, she will hurl a fire whirlwind. We can dodge it by moving to both sides. Lost Signora's 12th ability: when Lost Signora lifts her whip and spins it, she will split her whip into three and strike in a large AO in front of her. Both striking and lashing her whip out of the floor will deal damage. We can get close to her to avoid the damage when she uses this ability. Lost Signora's 13th ability: Lost Signora unfurls her wings and rains down three molten rocks. Just move around to avoid them. Lost Signora's 14th ability: when Lost Signora's health drops to half, she will transform into a tornado that moves around the arena, while summoning mini pyro tornadoes in intervals. At the end of the duration, Signora will spread her wings and largely increase blazing heat. During this phase, stay close to the Eye of Frost with a shield to resist taking damage throughout the process. These are all of Lost Signora's abilities. After dodging her attacks, we should focus on close-range attacks during her skill cooldowns. How about it? Do you feel that Lost Signora's skills are easier to dodge after this explanation? I hope every new traveler can clear the Lost Signora weekly boss after watching the video. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching.